Good evening, everyone. So, as usual, we will wait another 5 minutes so that most of the people can join us. We will wait 5 minutes so that most of the people can join us. So, before the start of this today's session, I just tell you that actually I was sick from yesterday. कल से मेरी तबीयत थोड़ी खराब है. So I was sick from yesterday. So still I felt that I should not take much gap so that your interest may continue. So I tried my best to conduct this class today only for you.
Sir, are you well now?
Yeah, presently bit okay. So anyway, so maybe you find some difference while I'm talking with you right now. So still I'm trying my best so that I can give my maximum to you. So I feel glad sometimes that so many people are taking interest on me. You're welcome. So anyway, so today, as you might have seen already the topic, so it was option one. So topic was option one. That means option was for mostly the beginners. Those who are not from the interior design background or from the architecture background. So I already mentioned them as option one, maybe the beginners to the interior designer, interior designing. So today is the option one class. So second thing, the topic, besides the topic, as I mentioned, the subject. So whenever you start to learn interior designing in any institute or wherever, you'll find the first subject, maybe in the diploma, maybe in the BSc first year, the first subject is always related to fundamental of design. The subject is fundamental of design. So in the fundamental of design, you will be learning lots of topics like basic introduction to interior design, elements of interior design, principles of interior design. These are the topics covering under the subject fundamental of design. So I also let you remember that I already conducted 2 or 3 classes. I've already conducted at the very initial start of this free online tutorial. I have already conducted 2 or 3 classes. Still, after that, I have found you, most of the people have joined us later after this class. So most of the people are new here. So I felt that I should, maybe I should repeat that class, or maybe I should teach you that subject in some different angle. So maybe a few of the people presently here, you might have already attended those classes. Anyway, the topic is today, fundamental of design, and the topic is to interior design. So anyway, maybe I am trying to let you know in some different angle today. So I will share some slides. Okay. So everyone can see on the screen. So just before start of interior design, most of the people who are not from the interior design background, there have some misconceptions, there have some doubts or confusions regarding interior design. So most of the people not from the interior design may find that if we are good in artifacts, if we are good in wall painting sketches, we can be an interior designer. Yes, you can be an interior designer. And few people, if you feel that I'm not good in sketch, I'm not good in drawings or paintings or making such artifacts or anything craft, I may not be an interior designer. This is also incorrect. So it doesn't mean whether you're good in making some craft artifacts or wall paintings or sketches, you can't be an interior designer. It's not like that. You can be. So I'll cover today in this topic, that what is the importance of creativity in interior design, that I'll be covering today in the basic introduction to interior design. So before that, I should also encourage and motivate those people. There are lots of people who are very fond of making such artifacts, making such wall paintings, sketches, and anything you prepare of your own due to your creativity. You are very creative in you. So you create such artifacts, you create such crafts, handlooms, and besides wall paintings, sketches you do. So I just let you know what is the difference between preparing such things and what is the implications to interior design, that I'll verify you right now. Suppose you are preparing such artifacts. You can see on the screen. I've just taken as an example. Suppose you have prepared a wall painting. This type of wall painting sketches you have made. So you have to know being creative, you have prepared such artifacts or you have prepared such wall painting, which may represent some elements or maybe some designs or maybe some natural abstracts, whatever, in different types of colors, of different types of colors. You have composed something for the wall painting you are proposing. So what will be the difference between only as an artisan who only prepares, only makes the paintings and the artifacts, and what is the difference between an interior designer? I will just let you know. Now, while you're observing, we're watching this wall painting, you feel that is very good. Bahut acha lag raha hai. It's very pleasant. Now, suppose you have to put this wall paintings to a room. Now, presently, you are watching the painting individually. You are feeling good because you are not into some comparison. You are not comparing these wall paintings you have made. Beautifully you have made. You are not in some comparison. You are feeling very good, pleasant. Bahut acha lag raha hai. Now, when it comes to comparison, that means if you put these wall paintings, wall sketches to a wall, this is the wall. So that is interior design actually. So only just by preparing any sort of crafts and artifacts or wall painting sketches is not the end of the interior design. You can say this is the start of the interior design. So until and unless you put those crafts, put those wall paintings in the room, and it is in comparison with the overall theme, comparison in overall theme, overall style of the room, then the interior design is complete. Then you can say the painting you have made is according to the style and theme of the room. So that is the interior design actually. So you never you let you think that only we are confined to preparing artifacts or wall paintings, anything which are a type of, which are a beginning of, which are a start of interior design is not the limit. You have to also consider that those things, whatever you have made, also should be in some uniformity, in some rhythm, in some abstract of the interior of the room. यानी उसको इंटीरियर एक रूम के अंदर लगाने के बाद कैसे कैसा लगेगा. अकेले सिर्फ मैं वॉल पेंटिंग को देख रहा हूँ, बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है, लेकिन क्या वो रूम के इंटीरियर के साथ जाएगा? क्या वो मैच होगा? क्या वो ओवरऑल थीम क्रिएट करेगा? दैट इज द इश्यू, दैट इज द पॉइंट वी हैव टू बी क्लियर इन इंटीरियर डिजाइनिंग. सो ऑलवेज यू कीप ऑन प्रिपेयरिंग वट एवर यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग राइट नाउ इन योर क्रिएटिविटी. यू आर मेकिंग स्केचेस, यू आर मेकिंग artifacts, you are making pots, coloring the pots, whatever you are doing is very good. But also you should remember that one time it has to be used in an interior designing. If it is in uniformity, in some style and rhythm or whatever you call, in the overall interior of the room, then it is okay. So just now I have shown you the images, the wall paintings individually. Now you, the other photo you are watching the same artifacts or what we call wall painting or sketches in the interior of the room, overall interior of the room ke sath match raha. So you can see, if you have prepared an image or wall painting in some combination of colors, composition of colors, that means the overall theme of the room will also suit for some combination of colors. So you can now relate the artifacts, relate the wall painting you have made with the overall interior of the room. So you can see the color of the sofa, the pillows of the sofa are in multiple colors, and the wall paintings we have made also is a composed of multiple colors. So there is a relation in terms of color, in terms of size, in terms of texture, in terms of overall composition, in terms of mass, in terms of scale. The size kitna bada hoga, kitna chota hoga, colors ka combination kya hai. So overall, if it suits the overall interior of the room, then it is okay. Now, as I told you, maybe in some other classes, interior design can be of various types. Maybe in broadly speaking, interior design can be in some classical style, can be in the modern style. I just cite an example. Suppose this is the interior design of a modern style. Suppose now in the modern style, in the wall, you can see there are two abstract paintings. In the modern theme, in the modern style of interior design, the wall paintings are more or less abstract design. Abstract. What is abstract? It resembles something, but it is not exactly that. That is some abstract painting. So you can see in the modern style of interior design, there is some abstract painting in the wall. In the wall, you can see there are two or three types of abstract painting. Now, just as I told you, whatever you are preparing of your own creativity, if you are composing for a wall painting, Now, presently, in this image of modern interior design, there are abstract paintings. Abstract paintings always goes with the interior theme of the project, interior theme of the room. Now, in the modern style, modern theme of the interior design, if you replace, in this image you can see, if you replace those abstract painting, you're replacing those abstract paintings, abstract modern paintings, you're replacing with some different craft design, craft type of wall paintings. It feels odd. Aapko odd lag raha hoga abhi. What does it mean? As I just now told you initially, so whatever you are doing, whatever you are creating, for a wall painting, wall sketches, or abstract painting, or any type of artifacts like a pot with colors, a flower vase, or artifacts, whatever you're preparing as an additional feature, as I told you, this type of additional features for interior designing, we call it a soft furnishing. So it has to suit with the interior of the room. So in the modern style of interior, we have to go for only, if you're proposing for a wall painting, it has to be in some abstract design only, not in some in this type of craft design. So that's why I was making you clear that you have to be clear that whatever you're making, it should suit an environment. It should suit and go with the theme of the interior. Then the interior design is complete. So these are some other examples of whatever you're preparing. Suppose you're preparing some artifacts with some use of local bamboo type or cane type of material, this type of things you're preparing. If you prepare it separately, if you don't compare it separately, it looks good. But when you come to the overall interior of the room, it has to suit the interior of the room. So it may be some composition. Just in this image, you can see the use of some bamboos or canes, jo locally Assam mein hum log shayad dala bolte hain. That is the circular in shape. It is of cane or bamboo. We can prepare it and we can color it. We have colored it in different sets of shades or whatever pattern we make in the craft. But it, whenever you made it and you watch it differently, separately, it looks good. But when you compose it for the interior of the room, then the main use of it will come. Then it should be looking good. So it may be some composition. I'm just citing some example. It may be some composition like this you can make. Another example, same, you can see on the screen. This is another example of using such bamboo or cane material, circular dish, which you can color in different colors and you can compose in size. There are different sizes of the compositions. You can compose it and maybe the back of the wall of the sofa or the bed, you can create it. So you have just to be clear that aap jo bhi bana rahe ho, it should suit with the interior of the room. It should not be looking odd. So it has to be in uniformity with the theme, uniformity with the style of the interior of the room. So there may be lots of examples here. Whatever you're making with, maybe say in some paper cut, you can make the flower patterns also, whatever you make. But you have to just think it that you have to use it for some interior of the room. Just keep in mind. Maybe the vase you create, the flower vase you create, compose. Just imagine that it should suit with the theme of the room. So there may be lots of examples. Now I come to the main topic today, the basic introduction. Okay, as I already told you that I have already conducted this class in before also, but I will just try to let you learn in some different angle. So as I wrote that today's topic was about the introduction to basic interior. Then basic introduction to interior, what is interior design will cover, what we use, why we use, why we need interior design will cover in this topic. So before that, I made you clear that most of the people who are not from the interior background, they might think, or most of the people, commonly people think that whoever creates this type of paintings, whoever creates this type of things are interior design. No. But that's why I made you clear that the difference between an interior designing and the difference between an interior decorator and difference between an artist or a sculptor and artisan. What an artisan's work limit is only limited to prepare the craft. An artist's work is limited only to create the painting, the wall hanging, banana, whatever the painting, wall painting. So artisans create the painters, the sculptors' work is only limited to create the object separately. He won't be thinking about the use of it, how to use the artifact, how to compose the artifact, how to create a marginity with the interior of the room. That is our part, interior designer's part. So always be clear. I'm repeatedly telling you, so the limit of the artisan's work, limit of the artist's work or the painter's work is only defined to only creating that particular object. He won't be comparing with the overall room, interior of the room. That will be our part, the interior designer's part. The painting, the wall sketches, the artifacts, the crafts, whatever you will be using as a soft furnishing of the interior design, will it suit with an interior designing? That is the part of interior design. That we call as interior design. So anyway, we come to the introduction, basic introduction to interior design. So now what we can define as an interior design. So most of the common people have the wrong misconception about interior design, that whoever can make good sketches, jo drawings pe bahut acha hai, color acha karta hai, painting acha bana deta hai, ya ghar pe kuch na kuch baith ke banata rehta hai, he is an interior designer. No, I always try to repeat you. Interior design involves both art and science. Without science, interior is not fulfilled or complete. Without art, interior is not complete. So interior design is always the science and art, combination of art and science. There is some part of art, there is some part of science also. Without science, you can't handle the interior projects. So if you want to study interior designing, we have to know that there is art and science. There are lots of things, the art, the creativity, there are lots of things of science we have to learn. So the general people have the common, as I told you, have a misconception that interior design just creates some paintings, just creates sketches, just create designs. Interior designer just creates some artifacts and wall paintings. No, these type of things are only we called interior decorations. So before that, you should also know one thing. There is a difference between interior designing and interior decorator. Normally, people think that the room, whatever the room has been suggested in some sort of small changes we are making, so they not be an interior designer. So there is a difference between an interior designer and an interior decorator. So I will just tell you what is an interior designer. Interior designer is one who not only studies the courses, who have the course of the interior designing. He or she is technical. He knows the creative part, the art part. He knows the science part. He knows all the services part. He knows what is the choice of materials, the durability of the materials he is going to choose, what are the science behind it, what will be the technique of making them, what will be the other scientific elements like the structure of the building, what are the structure of the building element parts, what are the services part, what are the plumbing, electrical part, how to make keep scopes in interior, how we have to keep the services scopes like the plumbing. Plumbing means the use of the pipelines, the water pipelines, inlet, outlet, whatever. So interior designer will study all the subjects in an interior design course, and he will be technical. He will be a technical person. He will not only decorate the room, he will decorate the room, but he or she will also know the technical aspects, all the types of techniques, methods to apply. What are the, as I told you already, what are the structural building elements? How to deal with the constraints, the problems in the site, how to keep the services scope. He also will be very technically sound in the services, building services part. He will be technically sound. He will know how to deal with the structural elements, how to deal with the services part, as I told you. And one more very important thing, an interior designer will also, as I previously in the last class, I already have the topic on units of measurements. So interior designer will also prepare drawings. He will prepare all the technical drawings to represent the site. But an interior decorator, what is an interior decorator? He or she will only confine to the decoration, the soft furnishing. As I told you, just putting the wall painting, the sketches, the artifacts in the room, and just by changing the wallpaper of the room is not an interior designer. These type of things are just soft furnishing. So soft furnishing part and interior decorator who may not be the technical person, he may not do a technical course or interior designer course. So that person who only is confined to soft furnishing of the room may be an interior decorator. So as we know, every human being has a self, natural instinct that whenever we stay in our own home, we sometimes feel there should be some changes in our interior layouts of the room, maybe in the drawing room, maybe in the bedroom. We sometimes get bored. हमें bore लगता है. Same type of design for long years, maybe 5 years to 10. We keep on feeling some changes. Also due to some services part, कुछ part खराब हो गया, कोई wall गंदा हो गया, it is dirty or the whatever the wall swelling part, whatever. So sometimes for many reasons, if we are not also interior designer, we feel that there should be some changes in the interior design. So what does these questions arise in our mind? This is the type of interior designing part or interior decorator mind. This is the part we call it that every human being is also an interior designer or decorator, because he also thinks of like that way. The difference is that if the person is not an interior designer, he won't be technically sound. He will be selecting of our own that I wish I could have been the color, the paint, wall paint color, maybe orange in my bedroom. He can suggest that much only, but he won't be knowing that what will be the impact of using orange color to the room, what will be the psychological effects, what will be the scientific effects in terms of color, in terms of light, in terms of humidity, in terms of AC consumption. He won't be know. That is the difference. So if you want to know the physical, the scientific aspects also, besides the psychological effects also, you have to be an interior designer. So this is the difference, general difference between an interior designer and interior decorator, or normally who are not from this background. So this is the main difference. Anyway, interior design is the art and science, and it is for the enhancing the interior or aesthetics of the space. Now I should also make you clear one thing. Often we call, whenever we visit some good places or even our own home, we do a new interior designing, or we visit a new place like restaurant or hotel, we see that we find the interior designing very pleasing, and often we call it very beautiful. So normal people who are not from the interior design background, they call the interior design beautiful, but in interior designing we call it aesthetics. There is a technical word. Aesthetics is a technical word to define beauty. So aesthetics, I will come give the definition after some time. So we call it aesthetics. So interior design is the art and science of enhancing the interior of aesthetics of the space or a building. Now I come to the next slide. I will just give you some brief definitions about that words. There are certain words, certain we have to know the meanings. These words have some technical meanings in interior design. So first, I should tell you why we call interior designing the art and science. What is the part of the art and what is part of the science? So art, as you can also read in the slide also, the art involves the creativeness, forms of expression, imagination and skill, origin of human mind. So what does it mean? What is art? Art is a creativity. That means something which originates from your own mind, which originates only in your own mind. You think something different. आपके दिमाग में कुछ अच्छा चल रहा है, आपके दिमाग में कुछ नया चल रहा है. यू आर समथिंग थिंकिंग ऑफ योर ओन, क्रिएटिंग ऑफ योर ओन, एंड यू वांट दैट टू बी इन प्रैक्टिकल. यू हैव सम डिजाइंस इन योर माइंड, यू हैव सम प्लानिंग इन योर माइंड, यू हैव सम क्रिएटिव इन योर माइंड, क्रिएटिविटी इन योर माइंड, ओनली माइंड में है अभी, एंड यू वांट टू मेक इट इन रियल. सो दैट इज आई एम टेलिंग यू, दिस इज द ओरिजिन ऑफ ह्यूमन माइंड, द ओरिजिनलिटी. You are not copying from someone. Maybe you might be inspired from some other design. Maybe you are inspired, but it is the origin of a man. Just like the poet, just like the lyricist who composes songs, just like the poet, what does he do? He has some creativity. He has some imagination in his mind. So that's why interior designing involves the art, the creation of your mind, of your own mind. You compose of your own. You think of your own. That is original, natural in your natural. It is not copied. So that is the originality, the creativeness of your mind. That creativeness can be a various type. Maybe in terms of color, maybe in terms of shape, maybe in terms of design, maybe in terms of pattern. Maybe you're fond of geometric shapes. I like geometric shapes. All are square, rectangle. These are the geometric shapes. Maybe you're inspired and you want to use all these geometric shapes into one form. That is maybe one creativity. Maybe you're fond of organic shapes. Organic shapes, the natural shapes, curves. Circular curves and everything. So maybe you are fond of natural shapes. So maybe in terms of color also, you like natural colors. green, brown, these are natural colors. So all this origination of your mind creates your creativity of your mind. You just try to input, output your creative of your mind to some basic types of drawings or sketches. So we need creativity. Maybe in terms of, as I already told you, many people are already doing some artworks like and artifacts, preparing a pot, changing the beer bottle to some flower vase. These are what? Creativity. These are the creativity, origin of your mind. You thought that I could convert this waste material to reuse. That is creativity. Maybe I color it, maybe I paste some decorative items over it, whatever. These are creativity. So it is very important to be an interior designer. You have to be very creative. But I should also make you clear, it's not necessary that you have some, if someone feels that I am zero in sketching, I don't know sketch, it doesn't mean you can't be an interior designer. Still you can be. Then you have to be clear that you are good in other subjects. So anyway, it involves art. So another thing, science. Why it is called, we use science in interior designing, because as I told you, you are creative in your mind. Now, whatever you are thinking, it's in your mind. You have to output it. You have to make it in some reality. So what is the process? Either you make some free sketches, freehand sketch. You create some freehand sketch first. From your mind, you create some freehand sketch. That is the origin of your mind. Now, is it possible for anyone, for a carpenter, for a mistri, for a layman, whatever, is it possible that from your freehand sketch, is it possible to make it in reality? No, it can't be made. Because in your freehand sketch, nothing is more prominent, nothing is more clear. There is no dimension. How will a carpenter, how will be a mistri walk? So that's why we need some drawings. There should be some standards of drawings. There should be some units of drawing. There should be some scales, measurements. As we already studied, units of measurements. So why we involve science? Because there should be some drawings. There should be some units of measurements, maybe in feet inches, maybe in meter, millimeter. So there is units of measurements. There is scale. There is proportion. There are many other applications of science, like the technical aspects. How to create this? What is the technique of using the laminate finish over the teakwood structure of the table? We know this is a table, but we should know what are the materials used in this table. What are the techniques of applying them? The main frame has been composed in some teak wood, and over that the laminates has been placed or the Korean sheet has been placed. How it is placed? What is the thick? What is this thickness? What is the adhesivity level? You should know the techniques of the properties of the materials also. You should know about the specifications. That means the specifications of materials. What is the cost of material? What is the durability of the material? What is this elasticity? What is this durability? What is this light consumption power? Everything you have to know about the materials. You have to also know the building services. As I already told, building services. What is building services? Building services involves the plumbing part, the electrical part, the HVAC part, the boilers part, the mechanical part. A building composed of many types of such services. सिर्फ एक घर बनाने से नहीं हो जाता, उसमें पानी के पाइपलाइन भी ले जाना है, सारा सॉइल पाइपलाइन भी ले जाना है, वाटर पाइपलाइन भी ले जाना है. सो एवरी पाइपलाइन, वाटर पाइपलाइन, इनलेट पाइप, आउटलेट पाइप, हाउ टू क्रिएट प्लेस देम, हाउ टू यूज देम, व्हाट आर द स्कोप्स यू हैव टू कीप इन इंटीरियर डिजाइनिंग. सो ऑल द बिल्डिंग सर्विसेज पार्ट, द एचवीएसी, हीटिंग वेंटिलेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग, द एसी पाइपलाइंस, हाउ टू हैव स्कोप्स टू टेक ऑल द एचवीएसी पाइपलाइंस, द फायर स्प्रिंकलर्स, द फायर अलार्म सिस्टम. All these building services also, we have to know the basic things so that we may be a good interior designer. So building services is another part. We call it as science, because without science, you can't learn the building services part. Another is the functional aspect. Functional means the use of space. How to use the space? What are the psychological factors? What are the anthropometric factors? What are the ergonomic factors? What are the psychological factors? Use of functional areas, not to waste any space. These are the another very many scopes of interior designer. So where we have to know the functionality of the building also, of the spaces also. So that's why it's a combination of art and science. So again, we are short of time today. So maybe we'll be continuing the next class also, this present topic. So I have just intentionally made it clear that interior designing is a combination of art and science. Always remember, don't think this is only art, on the art. Bas we have to draw, we have to sketch, we have to make beautiful. Saja dena hai, bas room ko color. No, I repeatedly in all the class I tell you, it's just when you will be in the profession, you will know why I'm telling you. You will remember me that sir has told us, yes, there is a technicality. You have to know all the constraints. You'll be facing many constraints and problems on site due to the technical aspects. The structure of the building, about structure of the building, maybe the beam comes, maybe the column, maybe the slab, maybe the pipelines, maybe the whatever. You'll face problems. So anyway, about the regarding the definition space. What is the space? Already told in the class. It is a platform, the empty space, the khali jagah, jahan pe hame kaam karna hai interior ka. Building, everyone is familiar. And any structural element, maybe an RCC building, maybe an Assam type building. The space, which creates space, which gives the space, the platform to work. Planning, plan, design. Okay. Planning actually is the stage, as I already told you in the previous class also. Planning is this is actually process. The day you start thinking, suppose you are presently talking about the interior of a room. Suppose the day you start about the interior of the room, the day it starts your planning, means it involves every stages, right from the whatever, as I told you, it creates the creativeness of the part. So planning involves the first, the day you start thinking, what will be the design, what will be the theme, what will be the style of my interior design of my room, what are the requirements, how to make the drawings, how to prepare drawings, what will be the furniture layout, what will be the choice of materials, what material I will be using, what will be the durability, how to execute them, how will the drawings be executed by the carpenter or the mistry. So everything, the day you start thinking till the end of the project, it accounts for the planning stage. Design. So while we are planning, you come to a stage called the preparation of the drawings. So while you will be preparing the drawings, as I told you, without drawings, an interior project design project cannot be executed. Just by thinking and preparing freehand sketch won't do. You have to make some specific drawings. So when you will be in the stage of preparing drawings, there are lots of styles, lots of themes you will be going on. So whatever choice of your style, theme, maybe classical theme, maybe modern theme, contemporary theme, you'll be carrying on. That process we will call it designing of the project. Another word is a plan. You should be clear that there this plan. There's a common word called plan. We often say plan. What is the plan today? Today we'll do this, like this or whatever. As plan kya hai? Yeah. But in technical term, in engineering field, in interior design or in architecture also, plan is a definite engineering term. Plan is a technical word. What is plan? Plan is a two-dimensional view, as I already in the previous class told you, two-dimension. So plan is a two-dimensional view of the space from above. But whatever we look from above in two dimension, the exterior outlines, two dimension. There is only two planes, two axes or two dimensions. So whatever we see from above, anything, maybe a room, maybe a furniture, that we call it plan. Elevation means you are sitting in the center of your room, and you have four sides of the room, four walls, front wall, back wall, side walls. So whichever one wall, one side of wall, you are watching from one side, from front, and you are watching it in two dimension. Again, two dimension you are watching, the vertical wall, the vertical surfaces. We call it elevation. And section means, as it is common term, section means whenever you slice it off, anything, maybe a brick block or a ceiling, you slice this off. Aap isko kaat dete ho, beech mein. You slice it off in between, and you want to see what is inside. What are the layers inside? Just like a brickwork. Brickwork, you are watching from as an elevation, you are watching from front. But you want to know what is inside the brickwork, you just slice it off, you cut it, and you see inside what are the layers. So anything which, and in two dimension, that we call it such section. So why we sometimes need sections in preparing plans? Because we have to know the layers. Suppose ek wall hai, wall ke upar paneling hai, wooden paneling ka design hai. You want to know what are the levels of paneling, what are the thickness of paneling. How will you know? 2D elevation won't give you that dimension. Obviously, you have to slice it off. You have to cut that wall into two pieces and see what are the layers. So section is a 2D, two-dimensional view also, thing also. Another 3D view, already I told you in the previous class also, 3D we already studied. So 3D is the actual picture, real look and feel you will give when we watch our drawings in three dimension. So we have lesser time. I'll just tell about the scopes of interior designing. What do you mean by this word scopes? Scopes means interior design ke paas kaun kaun si jagah hai jahan pe hum logo ko kaam karna hai. So in an empty space, in an empty platform, in a space, what we call space, the empty platform, what are the scopes? What are the surfaces we will walk as an interior designer? First is the flooring. Flooring, everyone knows flooring. Flooring the ground level, where you are standing, where you are sitting. That can be various types. Flooring can be in wooden flooring. Flooring can be in tiles or marble or granite. So flooring is the scope of work we interior designer do, and it can be of two types, soft flooring and hard flooring. Hard flooring means hard, which is permanent, fixed, like the tile, use of tile, granite, marble, wooden flooring. These are hard flooring. Another is soft flooring. Soft flooring means whatever we put above the hard flooring, maybe the carpet. Maybe the carpet is a soft flooring. Maybe the, sometimes we often put some mat, plastic wooden mat we put, PVC mat we put over the tile to give some rustic finish, to give some wood finish. We put mat also. Or in the soft carpet we put over the floor. So these are the soft flooring. Second one is the ceiling. Ceiling, the exact what we see above in the room. Aap jahan pe khade ho, aapke upar jo dikh raha hai, RCC slab. So this is another scope of interior designer. So we prepare the ceiling design. Ceiling design can be of various shapes, various designs. Ceiling can be in various materials like POP material, like in gypsum ceiling, like wooden ceiling, maybe in PVC ceiling. So materials can be different, shapes can be different, design can be different, but this is another scope where interior designer work. Another is the wall surfaces, the vertical surfaces, as I told you, wall surfaces. Wall surfaces can be vertical partitions, the wood, the brickwork, the paneling. Sometimes in the offices you might have seen there is no brickwork, but there is still some partitions. Maybe the partitions in aluminium, maybe the partitions in MS, mild steel, Loha, iron you say. So maybe some partitions in wood also. So whatever partition we have, vertical partition we have, there is another scope of interior designer. What we do in the wall, we may create some wallpaper, we make wall texture, we may put some paneling, wooden paneling, baffle paneling, whatever you do. So there are certain scopes of work for the interior designer. Also, to put, as I already told you, put our wall paintings, wall sketches, wall sculptures or portraits, whatever we put in the wall. So there is another surface, another scope of interior design in the wall surfaces. And the fourth one is the furniture. Furniture is a vast subject. Furniture, everyone is aware what is furniture. So furniture, broadly speaking, there are two types of furniture. One is the fixed furniture, one is the loose furniture. What is the fixed furniture? The wardrobe, the overhead tank or overhead cabinets, the modular kitchen. These are fixed furniture. We use them as furniture, but they are fixed. They are fixed. We can't be moved. And another type is the loose furniture. Loose furniture is the rest of the furniture which we can move from one place to another place. Just like the bed, sofa, table, chair. These are the loose furniture. So what are the scope of an interior design? We can also design the furniture. Customized design of the furniture also we can do. So another the thing is the furnishing. Furnishing is the end, is the last finishing over the furniture. Like the cushioning, putting the mattresses over the bed cover. Also in the windows, we put the blinds, we put the curtains. Also the carpet, maybe the floor mat. These are the soft, these are the furnishings. Furnishings can be of two types, soft and hard. So all these furnishings I was telling you right now are the hard furnishings. And soft furnishes, as I already told you, after completing all the furnishes, the curtains, so yes, of course, dal diya, mattresses, dal diya, sofa ke upar, leather finish, dal diya. The last soft furnishing will be you when you put the wall picture, wall photos, portraits you put. These are the type of soft furnishings. So I think the time is going to end up right now. So we will continue this class in the next this topic in the next class also. Okay. Okay, the time is over right now. So I won't be asking questions right now. The time is over, I think. So we will continue this subject, this topic in the next class also. We'll be covering what are the scopes of interior designing and practically why we need interior designing in spaces. We'll cover in the next class.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay.